Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threads. Today we'll see some Arriwork tassels that I got done recently. So this is one of our newest designs. Keeping in mind the kind of zari and buttas the sari had, I kind of got this design done. It's more like arch, but we have just given that small V shape like a drop, just to make it look a little different. And moreover, sari had kind of round buttas in the body, so I thought this kind of arch design will really complement it. So this next one is also one of my own designs. I recently got it done. This was loved by a lot of my customers. I think we worked about 8 to 10 saris of this design in a month. You must have seen this design in my mother-in-law's sari as well. So it looks very pretty because of that small jharkhand that is hanging. This is also arch, but it is an inverted arch. So I just try to bring some variation, you know, keeping arch in mind. So this came out really pretty. Here is a look of both together. So mostly it is the work is done in thread, and here and there we have used very little beads. So these kind of tassels, I mean, if you want, you can add a small crystal hanging. If not, also they look equally good. So this next one is my mother-in-law sari. You must have already seen in that video. But yeah, this is also Arriwork tassel, has cut work, but I have added some baby kuchu in between the Arriwork. So in case you do not like adding tassels here, you can add some crystals or bead hangings. So here we have used some pearls, and rest of it is in zari and thread. So these are all my new designs that I got done recently. So this is my mom's sari, you guys would have seen in that video. But this design looks really pretty, especially because of the you know, the colors in that sari. And for this particular design, I have used some crystal hangings because she likes it. This is also arch, and in the edge we have done some cut work. So this one, I added this bit so that you guys see the work clearly. I did not have videos of all the orders. We just managed to click pictures, but I keep posting on Instagram, so I take pictures. In case you are not following us on Instagram, follow Naughty Threads on Instagram and Facebook now. So this is one of our super hit Potli designs. I think you guys would have seen this work in my tutorial as well. In case you have not, please go back and check our playlist. So this is also done in Arriwork on cotton silk fabric. So this is one of our latest designs. Very soon you will get to see the close-up pic. The sari also was very beautiful, yellow and pink color combination. It's heavy ari kuchu. There is a peacock and floral design, and we have also added some baby tassels and crystal hangings. So this is how it looks. So this next one also is heavy work. Here we have a pair of peacock facing towards each other and mango design. The edge is arch shape where we've done cut work, and we have added some crystal hangings. So when you do ari tassels like this, you can pick up whatever is there in the sari and you know, work it in the pallu like this. So this next one is again a Potli design. You guys would have seen my tutorial already. It is again on cotton silk fabric. We do ari work, and then we stuff a pom-pom or a plastic ball inside, and then tie it as Potli, and then attach it to the sari. And a detailed video is already posted on this channel. I'll try to link it. If not, please check the playlist. So this particular sari was very heavy. wish I had some videos of this so that I could show you guys the work from close up, but unfortunately I did not take any videos, so I'm just trying to add pictures here. Very soon I will be posting the blouse of all these saris. The blouse work of all these saris is very heavy and interesting. So this is my sari. You guys would have seen in my sari collection video. Here we have done the arch cut work, plus the same design is little bit tweaked, and we have placed it one straight and one upside down. So that is how I like playing around with the designs. And also, I have not added any crystals. I mean, if you want, you can add crystals. While working these kind of ari kuchu, it is better you do it on the plain part of the sari instead of doing it on the zari part of the sari. If you're doing it on the zari part, the work will not get that highlighted. And this is my muhurtam sari. This is one of the heaviest ranged kuchu work we have right now. So this looks very, very pretty when actually, you know, the sari is draped. So this is one of my favorites, favorites among the favorite, I could say. So here we have used pearls, some matte beads, ring knots, zari, and in the bottom we have also hanged some bugle beads, or what we call as kardana. So here comes our recently worked waist belts. So this is one of the waist belt I worked for my customer. So it's again, this is worked on the blouse piece itself while we were working the blouse, and it is stitched. The edges we have done cut work, and then we have added some crystal hangings. So this is with dory. We have added four dories so that it fits anybody. So this next one is again a waist belt. We have hanged some beads and sugar beads and metal beads. This one has a straight line on the top and bottom. There is no cut work for this, and this is stitched with elastic. So you can do any ways, either elastic or dory like this. Probably dory would fit better. That is my personal suggestion, because sometimes the elastic might tend to lose its elasticity. This was done for a little girl aged about 3 or 4 years for her skirt and crop top. Along with that, I designed this waist belt for her. Here we have added some silver beads and crystals. So this is also stitched with dory. Now here comes our recent latkans. So this is worked in a single piece. Like, we work a round shape and then we fold it and stitch it along with the beads. So that's how this is done. And this one is a triangle shape. When you're doing round and folding it, you just have to work two pieces, but for shapes like this you will need four pieces. You will have to stitch them together and then hang whatever choice of your beads. I think there are tutorials in Ari playlist, so please do go check it out. I have showed very clearly how to make latkans. So this is a very interesting shape. This actually looked very pretty when she draped the sari. I have added matte beads in the bottom, and it is filled with French knots in the center. So this next one, the shape is not, it's a common shape, teardrop shape, but the bottom, these are all handmade in our boutique. So we have stitched both the pieces using some canvas fusing inside, and then we have added beads as the outer line, and added a thick tassel. So this also looks very pretty when worn. So this next one is a velvet latkan. So even this is in round shape. So the back and front both have to be worked, and then the outline we have used some matte beads. So that's these are the only pictures I could get from our recent work. Unfortunately, I was so busy in my wedding preparations that I could not take pictures of all the work, but I'll check if I have, I will be sharing them soon. So in this video, that's about it. In case you have not subscribed to our channel yet, do subscribe. If you like this video, hit that like button and share the video with your friends. Visit my blog naughtythreads.net. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Pinterest. I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care guys. Bye-bye.